I'm so excited, not only for this album, but for this vibe that we are living in right now. I'm thriving. Hey Beans, what's up? How you doing? How have you been? Let me know in the comments below. So today, once again, we are back with Lana Del Rey, and this time, we will be listening to Ultraviolence. I'm nervous, and you know why I'm nervous? Because of the 5 billion comments that I got that said, hey, you're not ready, you're gonna get hurt. Thanks for that. I was just listening to Born to Die, and I was vibing. It felt good already, and I'm so excited. I'm nervous, but I'm very excited. If you guys are new to this channel and you want to see more Lana content, be sure to subscribe down below if you want to. And I also have a Twitter and Instagram you guys can check out. Post a lot of behind the scenes, sneak peeks, lives, all that fun stuff. So if you want to check those out, links will be down in the description. And let's listen to Ultraviolence. So guys, my dog's in here. Just heads up, if you hear that, it's my dog walking around. If we take a look at the track list for this album, one, I don't know a single song of this album. I have not heard any of these songs, but what do I think will be my favorite? Ooh, I don't know. Sad Girl? That one caught my eye. Pretty When You Cry? Is This Happiness? It could be any of those. Honestly, it could be literally any of them because I'm kind of slowly but surely falling in love with Lana Del Rey. It's happening, and I hope that's okay with everybody. I'm nervous, but we're gonna start with Cruel World, which is literally what we're living in right now, so can't wait. Hey guys, it's editing Caitlin, and I just want to say, it's a few days since I've listened to this album, and I actually want to give you guys an update as of now, so make sure you hang around to the end of the video, because I'll come back and say some things that I didn't say at the end of actually filming my reaction, so yeah, just stick around for that, because yeah, I have some things I want to say. Cool. What a way to open. You're already like, you know. It's all over now. Aw. Did what I had to do. You like the party. And how fun. Why do I feel like I'm gonna die? Happy. Am I dead? Oh, she's happy then? That part almost, there was something David Bowie. I do this all the time. I relate things to David Bowie and I apologize, but rest in peace. I love you. I also just noticed that this song is like 6 minutes long, which I didn't realize. I don't really have, like, I don't know what to say right now because I just. That is like such an intense opening track. Why am I out of breath? Why can't I breathe? Oh my god. As always, it was like spooky, creepy, atmospheric, otherworldly, paradise, hell. I don't know that I can do this right now. Okay, I like how the first track just like ripped my soul apart. That was good. That's where we want to be right now. That's perfect. All right, next is the title track, which is Ultraviolence, which by the way, we didn't talk about it, but like Ultraviolence. We don't need to talk about it because you get it. Where are we going? I feel like I just like should close my eyes and like go to sleep. I don't know. Ultraviolence. I'm sorry, I missed the lyric and I just saw it. Fuck Jim. I have a feeling this entire video is going to be me not being able to speak, because what do you say? Oh, I'm sure there's a deeper meaning even beyond the obvious surface level story of the song. It's just so painful. Like, every line, we're not gonna keep crying. That's something we're gonna avoid. Just kidding. Okay guys, the next song that we have here is called Shades of Cool. Cool's for me, not for you. Why that lyric gets me, but it does. Oh, I love the way the chorus starts so much. Do you hear the layers? I heard a bird. How does she bring in so many different sounds? How does she do it? There's so many layers and so many sounds and so many genres and so, like, she's her own genre. Why am I always speechless? I'm sorry, I don't mean to be. I just feel that way. I can't help him, can't make him better. The bridge was insane. I'm sorry, that bridge was crazy. The production was so intense. The next song we will be listening to is Brooklyn Baby. This sounds less depressing. Hold on. Okay, I really like this one. Just the opening line, they say I'm too young to love you. It says so much in one line. So much is said in one. The whole tone is set right there. The whole tone. It's very vocal based. It's beautiful. Well, my boyfriend's in the field. Get down to beat poetry. Beat poetry? What is that? I like that too. It's so echoey and pretty. I love this guitar piece. You say I'm like ice, I freeze. I'm churning out novels like beat poetry on amphetamines. I mean, as always, I don't really think I can grasp the lyrics the way I'm supposed to, but the feeling's all there. I don't know if it was supposed to be as sad, but it was like really pretty, and there was, like, in the production, there was a somewhat more hopeful sound to it to me, but I mean, at the end of the day, I don't like want to go skip around right now, you know? The next song is West Coast. Oh my god, here we go again with these LA vibes. Ooh. Wait, whoa. Okay. It's a lot already. Oh, okay, I see. Hello, relatable lyrics. Also, I love the way she sings, like the melodies and the way she uses her voice in this verse. Whew, it's very unique. Ooh, it changes up so much. Like, the chorus sounds so different from the other parts of the song. Down on the West Coast, they love their movies, their golden buttons. Your love. The pre-chorus and the chorus are so opposite. It's weird how different they are. Whoa, I think I just like completely was out of it for the last like 20 seconds. I don't know where I went, but I wasn't here. I love, my favorite part of that is the pre-chorus because her melodies and her vocal in that is so different from her usual. I don't know if it's because it's a little bit faster paced or I don't know what it is, but it's different and I really liked it. And I love the lyrics in this. Again, way too complex for my brain, but I still loved them. Oh, next is Sad Girl. Oh, perfect. Great. Love to hear it. Ideal. No. Oh, but you haven't seen my man. What? Should be listening in like pitch black. You guys were right about it being a middle of the night album. It's not even dark enough right now. Like it's the middle of the night, but it's not even dark enough right now. I like want coffee right now. We're gonna pretend that while I was downstairs getting my coffee, I didn't hear a loud bang up here. Although if a ghost showed up, I feel like that would just complete the vibe. So like, come hang. It's cool. The next song is Pretty When You Cry. Something about that title is concerning, to say the least. Yeah, okay. Shine for you, my love. Am I the girl that you dream of? I'm not in pain. That's... No. Not this song. Oh, that drum though. The pre-chorus is too much for me. Okay, the most interesting part, unless I miss something, the title of the song is Pretty When You Cry, but the lyric is Pretty When I Cry. What's the reason? That's so interesting to me. Don't say you need me when you leave and you leave again. I'm stronger than all my men except for you. Okay. Also, like, good for you, Lana. I'm glad you're pretty when you cry because we know that I'm not. What's the next song? Money, Power, Glory. Oh boy. Oh shit, muffin on a stick. What is this?
Not what I want at all. I want money, power,
oh, your power. Oh. Okay. No, wait, do not start yet. I love that one lyrically because it's like, it hit me because in the chorus it says, I want money, power, and glory, which is one thing, but then to say, I want money and all your power, all your glory. Like, oh shit. Oh. Still don't really know what it means, but that does make a difference in the song, in my opinion anyway. Fucked my way up to the top. Oh. I'm a little concerned about this one. We're at the top of a dark tower. Oh. Oh, I love that. I started like reading some of the stuff on Genius, which I don't always do, but some people are saying it's about Lorde dissing Lana for saying her music was unrelatable, too glamorous, makes women seem submissive, is about unhealthy relationships. Whoa, 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 whoa. How? Alright, see, this is where I fail, because even knowing what the song is about, looking at the lyrics, how in the hell is it about Lorde? But where? I don't even know where the connection is, but I will say I loved that song. Based on the title, I was like, ooh, no. Like, I'm not gonna like it just based on the title. But I love the chorus and the whole sound of it. It was beautiful and haunting and terrifying all at once. Okay, next is Old Money. She sings a lot about money. This song would hit hard, but it's hitting really hard. Sounds like she's in pain with those ow, ah. Okay, I think that has to be another one of my favorites. Between, the lyrics hit really, like, the entire verse and the choruses, like, all of it, hello, all of it. It's just, the story of listening to Lana Del Rey. I don't know, I feel like this reaction's weird. I feel like I'm not saying much, but I don't know what to say because I'm just feeling everything and it's hurting. It's also the middle of the night, I'm a little out of it, so that's probably part of the situation. All right, so the next one is The Other Woman, and I just read at the top, it's a cover of a song by Nina Simone. So this one is a cover, much like Blue Velvet was a cover.
The other woman.
Ooh.
As time is perfect where rival fails.
Okay.
Cause to be
I know these aren't her lyrics, but I mean, the lyrics are, they're more straightforward, I guess, but you know, just the idea that the wife is, you know, probably like too busy and like, you know, has more of a complicated life, whereas the other woman probably lives like a rich, simple, single lifestyle where she can do whatever she wants. And yeah, that's kind of usually how it goes. But the way she's singing this is, it's so interesting. I don't know what the original sounds like, but this, it's like, sort of casual grand, which doesn't make sense, but it does at the same time.
What?
Oh, the plot twist. Everything about the way she produced that song was devastating. Because it was that kind of like I said, this like casual grand sound, which isn't actually a thing, I'm making that up right now. The production was lonely. Even though it was grand, it was lonely. Does that make any sense? No, but it happened. What is next? Black Beauty, okay. Excuse me?
I paint my nails black. I dye my hair. Darker shade, so it suits the mood of your soul.
I just want to literally feel the music. Wow, okay. That felt like the deepest song on the album for me personally. Like, where's the lyric? Where's the lyric? Where's the lyric? Where's the lyric? You said if you could have your way, you'd make it nighttime all today so it suit the mood of your soul. Shit. Okay. Life is beautiful, but you don't have a clue. Sun and ocean blue, their magnificence. It don't make sense to you. This is so dark. Black Beauty. That one, that's definitely one of my favorites. I think it's just, it's so deep and meaningful and perfect and beautiful and heartbreaking. The next song is Guns N' Roses. Oh?
Have you met all of mine? Cause you are so much better than the rest of them.
The one that got away. Oh, Guns N' Roses, duh, okay. Oh. I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Yeah, the Phil Collins song. Okay, so that was Guns N' Roses. Really pretty song, but hard to relate to for me on this one. Probably not one of my favorites, but I mean, it was still a really pretty song, but as of right now, not one of my favorites. The next song is Florida Kilos. This sounds a little different. I like her voice on this. Oh, she's saying yayo again? Interesting throwback to another song. I like this part for some reason. Wow. Okay, so that was Florida Kilos. I feel the same way about this one that I do about Guns N' Roses. Pretty song, but definitely not my favorite. I liked a lot of the earlier ones a lot better. But this takes us to the two songs that are not on Spotify that I have to go to YouTube for, which are Is This Happiness and Flipside. So we'll start with Is This Happiness, which as a title could go one of two ways. Oh, the piano. I like it. That one, I think, is beyond heartbreaking. For me, like, just saying, is this happiness is, like, wanting this happiness and looking for it, and then getting there and being underwhelmed and asking, is this really happiness? Like, that's what that song made me think of, and it was, like, you know, kind of painful. And I love the piano, the instrumental, her vocal, everything was just so perfect in that song. I'm surprised it's one of the ones that's not on Spotify, because, I mean, I'm not surprised, I'm just, like, disappointed, because that, I think, might be one of my favorites. Okay, this takes us to the last song that we'll be listening to from this album, which is called Flipside. Whoa. I feel like we're in space with this one. We're like on the moon right now. Nostalgic. I don't know how she makes you feel nostalgic, but she does. Again, we're back on the moon. That song easily should have been on the actual album. Might be my I don't know if it's my number one favorite, but it's one of my favorites. Lyrically, like, relatable on every single level. The chorus, you don't want to break me down, you don't want to say goodbye, and you don't want to turn around, you don't want to make me cry. You call me once, maybe on the flip side I could catch you again. Beautiful. Oh my god, that should have easily been on the album. Okay guys, so That's it. We have officially listened to Ultraviolence. I'm feeling a little weird, a little strange, a little off after listening to this album. And I don't know exactly why. I don't know exactly what it is. But I definitely need to give this album some more listens. Some more late night listens, some more day listens, some more drive listens, whatever. I need to give it more listens because right now, I'll be 100% honest, I think I like Born to Die as a record better than Ultraviolence. Now, I've had more time with Born to Die. I've listened to Born to Die multiple times at this point, and it did take me time to get used to Born to Die, so now I need my time to get used to this album. I just feel like these songs didn't sit with me the same way that songs on Born to Die did. They just haven't stuck with me the same way. So I'll try to give you guys an update in a few days when I'm editing or whatever and let you know if anything has changed. I need more time. That's all I can say is I need more time. But when I am editing this, you guys, this is my ranking of Ultraviolence. What do I think is going to be on the top? Well, definitely Flipside. Brooklyn Baby was good. Pretty When You Cry. Old Money. Black Beauty was really good. I think those are my favorites as of right now. Yeah, I don't know, guys. I think part of the problem, to be completely honest, like if I'm gonna be open and honest with you guys, is that all the comments on my Born to Die video were hyping up this album so much and telling me that it's so much better than Born to Die. So I think I came in with these kind of unfair high expectations and then it just didn't live up to that for me. I'll try to give you guys an update right here. Okay guys, so today is Monday. I filmed this, I believe, Saturday night, so it's only been a couple days. I haven't had a lot of time to really listen to the album a lot since then. I've definitely listened a few times, but not like all the way through or anything. Anyway, I've kind of nailed down some of the reasons I felt the way I did about the album, and I just wanted to quickly share those with you guys. A lot of what happened by the end of filming that was I was filming for like an hour and 40 minutes at least, and I think by the end, I kind of forgot what I'd listened to at the beginning, especially because I think with this album, it's a lot more of the same sound, whereas Born to Die, I think, had more variety in the different tracks. I don't know if that makes sense, and that's not an insult at all. I just think Ultraviolence had more of a cohesive all the way through sound, and so by the end, I was like not really able to remember all the different songs, but editing this, I noticed like nearly every song, I was like, wow, 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 this is beautiful. This is beautiful, this lyric, whatever. So going back and looking at it, I think I can really just say by the end, I kind of forgot all the things I loved. I wrote down, I was trying to take notes, I forgot the individuality of the songs by the end of filming. Just, you know, for it being like 2 hours or whatever. I would say a couple days after filming this, I still prefer Born to Die over this album, but again, I've only listened to this a couple times and Born to Die a lot more, but that's not saying that I don't like Ultraviolence. Again, I think I noticed in editing how much I did actually like it and kind of didn't even realize it. I guess it just wasn't as good for me as Born to Die / Paradise, and everyone made me think that I was gonna love it so much more. So that's like where things kind of got all mixed up in my head. I don't know, I hope that maybe clears things up. Maybe it doesn't, I'm sorry. Okay, duh, I also almost totally forgot to include the part where I think the other thing that happened was the album was so like emotionally taxing that I just felt very eh by the end. It's just a hard album to listen to and I think that also affected it. But yeah, sorry, I forgot to add that part and I meant to, I'm sorry. So the next album that we will listen to is Lust for Life, which is from 2017. So if you guys want to catch that, feel free to subscribe if you want to, totally up to you guys. But thank you so much for watching as always. I love you so much from my whole heart. I appreciate your support forever and always. Thank you guys for watching and I will see you in my next video. Bye!